लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ केस नंबर टू. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ अ न्यू केस. राइट डाउन केस टू. ओके एंड द केस इज, राइट डाउन द केस, द ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग विथ अ यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी ऑफ 2 meter per second. Okay. This is our case. Now let me make it very clear what you are going to do. You are having a graph paper, and on the graph paper you will find there are two sides of every paper. So you are going to write on the blank page, you are going to write the case, you are going to draw the table, and you are going to write all the important conclusions. You are going to write all the important conclusions, table, case on the blank page of the graph paper. And on the graph paper, you are going to draw the graph. Okay, so it will be like this. But if you are having a graph book, so obviously there is no blank page, then you use your regular, notebook for writing the case, the table, and the conclusions. You have to use your regular book. Okay, so what's the case? The object is moving with a uniform velocity of 2 meter per second. Write down the case. The object is moving with a uniform velocity of 2 meter per second. That's our case. Copied. Now, what we are going to do, bachcha log? Now we are going to look at the table of it. Okay, how the table will look like. Okay, so we start with the sheet. Okay, now here, how long we are going to take the reading? So we are going to take the reading for 5 seconds. Okay, now I have mute you all, so now you have to respond. You have to give the response through the chat. Okay, so 0 second, the object is at the initial position. Okay, but now the object is moving with a velocity of uniform velocity of 2 meter per second. Means in every 1 second, the object is covering 2 meters. Okay, so in every 1 second, the object is covering 2 meters. So can you say me how much will be the displacement after 1 second? Very good, Avni. Yes, Nishant, Swam, very good. After 1 second, what will be the displacement? It will be 2 meters. Very good. After 2 seconds, what will be the displacement? Total displacement? 4. Very good. Why? Because the object is moving with a uniform velocity of 2 meters per second. So after 2 seconds, the displacement will be 4. After 3 seconds, the total displacement will be 6. Why it will be 6? Because in every 1 second, the object is covering 6 meters. After 4 seconds, very good. After 4 seconds is going to be, 8. And after 5 seconds, so you'll find that after 5 seconds, the displacement will be 10. The total displacement will be 10 after 5 seconds, because the object is covering equal distance in equal interval of time. Okay. Now this is our chart. So please, this is our table. Quickly draw this table, beta. Okay, displacement and time. 0, 0, 1, 2, 2, 4. Draw this. Okay, now we have to plot a graph. Now, please ensure that you have to draw a graph. So, you are, especially your y coordinates. Okay, don't take it till 10. Ensure you take it at least till 25. Okay, take it at least till 25 or 30. Okay, your y coordinates especially. Because on this very graph, we are going to draw multiple graphs. On one graph only, we are going to draw multiple lines, multiple motion. Okay, so how the graph will look like? Okay, so if you look at the coordinates, it's 0, 0, 1, 2, 2, 4, 3, 6, 4, 8, and 5, 10. Let's look at the graph, how it will be. So our graph will something look like this, isn't it? So this is how our graph is looking. See, this is the first coordinate 0, 0. Then this is the second coordinate 1, 2, x-axis 1, y-axis 2. This is second coordinate, x-axis 2, y-axis 4. Third coordinate, x-axis 3, y-axis 6. Then x-axis 4, y-axis 8. And then x-axis 5 and y-axis 10. So this is our focus. So how we are getting it? Okay, so you will find that we are getting a straight line inclined to x-axis. What we are getting? So we are finding that we are getting a straight line which is inclined to x-axis. So the very important thing now, please draw this graph and write down how we are going to read it. So the line, it is a, as you can say, it's a straight line inclined to x-axis. What it is? It's a straight line inclined to x-axis. Okay, so this is something. We will find that it's a straight line inclined to x-axis. Now, what we will do? So we will do one thing, class, and we will find the slope of this. Okay, how we are going to read this line first of all? So we read this line as it's a straight line inclined to x-axis. How we read this? We read it as a, it's a straight line inclined to x-axis. This is how we read it. You remember when the object was at rest, how we read that line? It is a straight line parallel to x-axis. This is a straight line inclined to x-axis. Okay, now the second important. Okay, now we have to find the slope of this line. What we need to do? We want to find the slope of this line. Okay, so first let's talk about slope. So what is slope? So what is slope? So slope is nothing but it is the measure of steepness of a line. What it is? It is a measure of steepness of a line. Means how steeper the line is. If you want to measure it, how steeper the line is, we call it as a slope. Now, how to find the slope? Let me tell you how we will find a slope, because I'm going to ask you to find the slope every now and then. So, what we do to find the slope, we take arbitrarily any two points. What we do? We take arbitrarily any two points from this line. We choose arbitrarily any two points from this line. So assume the first point I have chosen is this one. This is the first point which I have chosen. Okay. That's my first point which I have chosen. Okay. Which is that? This is the first point, and I will choose this one. So these are the two points which I have chosen. This point will be my x1, y1, and this point will be my x2, y2. Obviously, because every coordinate has x and y, every point has the x and y coordinates with it. So this is my x1, y1, and this is my x2, y2. So we are arbitrarily going to choose any two points. So let me decide x1, y1 first. So my x1 is 2 and y1 is 4. Okay, so I have to find out x1, y1. So x1, y1 is equal to, what is my x1? 2. What is my y1? 4. Okay, this is my x1, y1. And I will choose another point. Assume I have taken this. So this is my x2, y2. This very point is my x2, y2. Okay, so which is, what is my x2? 5. What is my y2? 10. So my x2 and y2. What is my x2? 5. What is my y2? 10. Okay, so if you want to find the slope, the formula for slope is, what's the formula for slope? The formula for slope is y2. Minus y1 divided by x2 minus x2. OK, Okay, this is how you are going to find the slope of any line. What you do? First, you arbitrarily choose two points. First point will be your x1, y1. Second point will be your x2, y2. Okay, and then you have to use a formula, that is y2 minus y1 is equal to x2 minus x1. Now, what is y2? So here you will find my y2 is 10 minus y1. What is my y1? My y1 is 4. So y2 minus y1, that is 10 minus 4 divided by x2 minus x1. What is my x2? x2 is 5. What is my x1? x1 is 2. So we get the answer. What's the answer? 10 minus 4 divided by 5 minus 2. So 10 minus 4 is 6. 5 minus 2 is 3. So 10 minus 4 divided by 5 minus 2. What's the answer? So you find the answer is coming out to be 2. Yes, beta Nitya. Very good. So what's the slope of this line? So the slope of this line is 2. Exactly. What's the slope of this line? The slope of this line is 2. Look at something very interesting we can find out. So you find that the slope of the line is 2, and what was the magnitude of uniform velocity? What was the magnitude of uniform velocity? So you find that the magnitude of uniform velocity is also 2 meter per second. Okay, what is the magnitude of uniform velocity? The magnitude of uniform velocity is also 2 meter per second. And what is the magnitude of slope? So the magnitude of slope is also 2 meter per second. Exactly. So it leads us to a very important conclusion. Please write down this important conclusion. Write down this beta, because this is very important. Important conclusion. Write down. And what it is? So write down the slope of displacement versus time graph. The slope of displacement versus time graph gives us the magnitude of velocity. What it gives us? The slope of displacement versus time graph gives us the magnitude of velocity. Now, Ruchir has asked me one very interesting question, and he's asking that, sir, what's the unit of slope? Okay, now, if you want to find out the unit of slope, it is actually the steepness, but still, if you want to know, it's very simple. What's the formula of slope? So the formula for slope is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So y upon x, if you look at it little carefully, you will come to know it is y upon x. So what is there on the y-axis? So if you check it on the y-axis, we have displacement, and the unit of displacement is meters. And on the x-axis, we have time, and the unit of time is seconds. So if you want to know the unit of slope, so it will be the unit on y-axis divided by unit of y-axis divided by unit of x-axis. And if you check it carefully, you will come to know that what is the unit of y? Meter. And what is the unit of x? Second. So the unit will be meter per second. Unit, Ruchi, is it clear? Haan, bacha, you get the answer of your question? Okay. So what is the slope giving us? So the slope gives us the magnitude of uniform velocity. So that is very important, that when the object is moving with a uniform velocity, we get a line. How the nature of the graph is? So we get a straight line inclined to x-axis. And just by finding the slope of this line, we can calculate the magnitude of uniform velocity. Clear, class? I hope you are getting it. Any doubt, please ask. Otherwise, I will proceed. चलो नाउ ऑन द सेम ग्राफ, ऑन द सेम ग्राफ आई एम राइटिंग अनदर केस, दैट इज ऑब्जेक्ट. Write down object moving with a uniform velocity of 3 meters per second. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to plot a graph on the same graph. Yeah, you don't have to change the graph, on the same graph, Om, on the same graph you have to plot a graph of a motion of an object moving with a velocity of 3 meters. Chalo, so let's start. Now initially the object is at rest, but after 1 second, what will be the displacement? Now what will be the displacement? So you will find the displacement will be 3. After 2 seconds, what will be the displacement? So it will be 6. After 3, it will be 9. After 4, it will be 12, and after 5 it will be 15. Okay, yes beta Mahesh, it's the same case, but one more type of it. It's the same case. Okay, don't change the case. So what we have the displacement versus time graph. Okay, so this is our table. X-axis 0, y-axis 0, then x-axis 1, y-axis 3, x-axis 2, y-axis 6, then 3, 9, 4, 12, 5, 15. So this is our another line. Let's see how we get a line on the graph. This is what we are getting. How we are getting it? So we are getting another straight line. What we are getting, class? We are getting another straight line inclined to x-axis. Okay, so how we are getting it? See, 0, 0 is there, but then 1, 1, 3, 2, 6, 3, 9, 4, 12, and 5, 15. Quickly draw this and find the slope.
Hello, ma'am. Good morning. I'm going to talk to you.
So what's the slope of this line, the second line, the orange line? Very good. What's the slope? The slope is 3. And look at the relation. Look at the relation. See, the object is moving with a uniform velocity of 3 meter per second. What's the slope of the line? The slope is also coming 3. So what we have concluded, that the slope of a displacement versus time graph uses the magnitude of velocity. So by finding the slope of a line, you can easily find out the velocity of that object. Yes beta, that's the right formula, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x. That's the formula for slope. Use it. Take two coordinates. The first coordinate will be x1 y1, the second coordinate will be x2 y2, and then put it in the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, and you find a. Now look at these two lines. What can we figure out? You can see that the first line is a straight line inclined to x-axis, and the second is also a straight line inclined to x-axis. This, the blue line, is of an object moving with a velocity of 2 meters per second. And the orange is a line which indicates that the object is moving with a velocity of 3 meters per second. So what is the difference you find between these two lines? Please give your opinion through the chat. I'm asking you, what is your opinion as long as the line is concerned? I am not talking about the slope. You can easily find out the slope. But about the line. Please give your opinion, class. Very good, very good. Okay. Very true. But how many of you are giving the beta Soumya? The line is longer, is not actually the difference. You will find, look at the steepness of the line. Okay. What Ruchir is saying is so true. Look at the steepness of the line. Okay. You will find that the steepness of the line is increased. Exactly. Yes. Om, it's a straight line, beta. Both, whenever it is a uniform velocity, whenever it is a uniform velocity, you will always find it will be a straight line inclined to x. Whenever it is a uniform velocity. But here, since both the cases, the object is moving with a uniform velocity, so both the lines are a straight line. But look at the inclination. Look at the steepness of the line. And you will find that the steepness of orange is more. Exactly. So, more the steepness of the line, more is the velocity of a moving object. Write down this again important thing. More is the steepness of a line, more is its velocity. Exactly. So write down this all thing. Yes, very good, beta. It is more steeper, steeper. More is the steepness of a line, more is its velocity. Clear, class? So you can easily find out that from the chart that this object, the orange one, is moving with a velocity of 3 meters per second. Chalo, now what we will do quickly on the, we will, on the same case, in the same graph, we will plot the object moving with a uniform velocity of 5 meters per second. The object moving with a uniform velocity of 5 meters per second. Yes, you have to draw it on the same graph, beta. That's what I said. We are not changing the graph. Okay, so let's use here, it will be 0, 0. Now, same after 1 second, what will be the displacement? After 1 second, the displacement will be 5. After 2 seconds, what will be the displacement? Ohm, the object is moving with a velocity of 5 meters per second. Beta. So, after 2 seconds, it will be 10. After 3 seconds, 15, after 4 seconds, 20, and after 5 seconds, 25. Exactly. So, this will be the displacement of the object because the object is now moving with a velocity of 5 meter per second. Now, let's look at this graph. See how it is? The graph is something like this now. Okay. So, you can easily find out that this line is now more steeper than the previous. Exactly. This was for 2 meters per second, blue, orange was for 3 meters per second, and this grayscale, it is for 5 meters per second. So what you find regarding the steepness of the line? So you find that the steepness of this line is 5 meters per second. If you find the slope of it, even you find the slope is coming out to be 5. Okay, so this again gives us a evidence that more the magnitude of the velocity, more steeper the line you will get. Exactly. If the velocity is more, the steepness of the line is also going to be more. Getting it, class? Okay. Now, since we have drawn this 3, don't draw the another one. Don't draw the another one. I'm just showing you. Okay. I'm just showing you that I will take one more case. And here, the object is moving with a velocity of 10 meters per second. Okay, so 0, after 1 second, 10, after 2 second, 20, after 3 second, 30, 4 second, 40, and 5 second, 50. Okay. So now the fourth, you don't have to draw it. I'm just showing you. The object is moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second, and see how the graph. This is how the graph. So my yellow line is far more steeper than the previous. Exactly. So let's conclude something very interesting out of this. Okay. You see a black line which I have drawn. Now, what does a straight line parallel to x-axis indicate? It indicates that the object is at rest. Exactly. So, whenever it is a straight line parallel to x-axis, it indicates that the object is at rest. Okay. If it is a straight line on the x-axis, what does that indicate? It indicates that the object is at rest at the initial position. Clear? What does it indicate? That the object is at rest at the initial position. But as you find, now look at this line. Now I am increasing the steepness of this line. Exactly. Now what can you say about assume? Now we will name it like this. This is blue car, this is orange car, this is gray car, and this is yellow car. And this one is the black car. Now what can you say about the black car, the velocity of black car? I want all of you to give your opinion. What can you say about the velocity of the black car? Please, there are around 32 students in the class. Come on, quickly say me, what is your opinion about the black car? Very good. No, I want very good, Avni, least velocity. Ruchi, don't say very slow. Say some more technical terms. Very good. Swam, the velocity of the black car is the least. Which type of motion the black car is having? Which type of motion the black car is having? Sure. Avni, it is non-uniform, beta. Is it a straight line inclined to x-axis, Avni? Avni? So whenever it is a straight line inclined to x-axis, what does that indicate? It indicates that the object is moving with uniform velocity. So what can you say about the motion of the black car? The motion of the black car is, it is moving with uniform velocity. Clear? But what can you say about the magnitude of that velocity? The magnitude of the velocity of the black car right now is the least, because the slope is minimum. Now what can you say about the magnitude of the what can you say about black car now? Very good, Avni. But there are handful of students who are responding. What about other students? Please respond, bachcha log, all of you. Only Avni is there, and then Om is there, Aditya is there, and I have very handful of students doing. Avni, Om, Aditya, Swam, Ruchi, bas. Itne hi bachche, baki ke sab kahan hai, baba? Come on, I want all of you to respond. Say me, what is your opinion about black car right now? Again, the same students are responding. Om is there, Aditya is there. What about other students? I want all of them to respond. I want all 32 answers here now. Yes. Very good, Monish. Brilliant. Very good, beta. I am talking about compare the velocity with other car. Ruchir, I am asking you to compare the velocity, beta. Come on, quickly. Students, I am waiting for you to respond. I am having same handful of students. Ruchir is there, Swayam is there. Rest all of them are not responding. Should I read out the names of these students now? Those are not responding. Ayush is there, Aditya is there, Aryan is there, Krish is there, Mahesh, Nidhi, Nitya, Piyush, Purva, Priyanka, Raunak, Riya, Rayansh, Rishi, Sanika, Soumya, Savani, Sejal, Soham, Swayam, Tanish, Tanushri, Vidula, Viraj and Yash. What about you people? You don't want to respond, beta? Very good. Now Mahesh is asking, can you repeat the question? I am asking you, Mahesh, about the velocity of the red car, a black car. What can you conclude about the black car? Okay, so the velocity of black car is now more than orange and more than blue, but less than purple and yellow. Now it is more than purple because the slope is more. Now it is more than, definitely it is more than red as well, because more the slope, more is the velocity. Now my question is, we can have a graph like this. Now what does this line indicates? A black line. It indicates that the object's velocity is even more. So if the steepness of the line increases, what we can say? The steepness is also increasing. But now if I keep it like this, on the y-axis itself, is it possible to have such motion? I want all of you to respond. Is it possible to have such a motion where my line is exactly lying on the y-axis? Okay. I want all of you to respond. So most of them are giving the right answer. Okay. But most of them, those who are giving is the right. But I'm not getting that ample amount of responses from you people. I want more response from your end. Now, can you say me the reason? Ruchir has given me the reason. Now others, apart from Ruchir, I want all others to give me the reason as why it is not possible. Come on, type your answers. I want to see why it is not possible to have a straight line on the y-axis. Very good, Avni. Very good, Monish. Very good, Avni. Swayam, there is no displacement. Sure. Do you think there is no displacement, Swayam? You are wrong, Swayam. Think of it. Displacement cannot occur with time, without time. Okay. Nishan, can you give the reason? No, beta Aditya. It has nothing to do with it being a vector quantity. No, beta Aditya. It has nothing to do with whether it's a vector quantity or not. No, Om. The velocity is not zero. Om. I'm sorry. Om. Just calculate, do the calculation properly for velocity. You will find it's not zero. Okay, chalo, let me give the reason why we cannot have a straight line exactly on the y. The reason is that, what does it mean that the object is at the beginning of the time, the object is at zero, then at the beginning of the time, the object is at 10 meters, or at the same time, the object is at 20 meters as well, or at the same time, the object is at 30 meters, the object is at 40 meters, the object is at 50 meters, and the object is at 60 meters as well. In fact, it's a straight line, so you can find that the object is at all the places. The object is at all the places at the same time. Or if I take it like this and I keep it here. So what does it mean? It means that at 2 seconds, the object is at the initial position. At 2 seconds only, the object is at 10 meters. At 2 seconds, the object is at 20 meters. At 2 seconds, the object is at 30. At 2 seconds, the object is at 40, at 50, and at 60, and so on. So what does it mean? It means that the object is at all the places at the same time. Is it possible for any object to be at all the places at the same time? No, it is not possible for any object to be at multiple places at the same time. At 2 seconds, you will find at 2 seconds, the object is at 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Is it possible for any object? No, it is not possible for any object to have such type of motion, even not for light as well. The fastest thing on this earth or on this world, in this universe, is light, but even light cannot have this. Okay, so if you find a slope of this line, all of you, please find the slope of this line, the black line. Quickly find out and say me what answer you are getting. Find out the slope of this line and let me know what answer you are getting. Find out the slope of the line. Take one point as x1, y1. Take another point as x2, y2. Then use the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 and say me what is your answer. No, Om, your answer is wrong, beta. No, Om, again it is wrong. Swam, it is wrong. No, beta Avni, it's not x2. Do it properly. No, Sanika. No, what mathematical answer you get? No, Rayans, it's wrong. It's wrong, Rayans. No, Om, it's wrong. Swam, it's wrong. Ruchi, that's right, but I want the mathematical answer. Mathematical answer. Okay. Chalo, let's take 2 points. Okay, I will take this point, which is x2y10. Okay, let's take it. x2y10 and then x2y15. These are my 2 points. See. x1, y1. Okay, so my x1 is 2 and y is 10. And then x2, y2. And you will find my x2 is 10 and y2 is 50. These are the 2 points I have taken. Now, y2 minus y1. What is y2? 50 minus y1. y1 is 10. Divided by x2 minus x1. x2 is 2 minus y1 is also 2. So what I will get? So you will find the computer is showing the error, but if I edit it, you will find that 50 minus 100 is 30 and 2 minus 2 is 0. Very good. Moni, so what's the answer? So it is some number divided by 0. All of you, according to your point, you must be getting, in my case, I'm getting 40 divided by 0. Some of you may be getting 10 divided by 0. Some of you may be getting 20 divided by 0. So can you say me what will be the answer if anything is divided by 0? Can you say me what's the answer? No, no, no. If a number is divided by 0, it is equal to infinite. And if 0 is divided by any number, then it is zero. Remember these two concepts. Remember, beta, any number, if you divide it by zero, it is infinite. You can talk to your math teacher to get the answer of this. So any number divided by zero is infinite, and zero divided by any number is zero. Clear? So there's a big difference between infinite and zero. So what is the speed? So the speed of this object, the black object, is infinite. It is moving with infinite speed, and there is no object in this world which can move with infinite speed. Every object, even light, has a finite speed. So is it possible for any object to be having such a motion? No, class. It is not possible for any object to be a straight line parallel to y-axis. Is it possible a straight line parallel to x-axis? And the answer is yes, it's possible. We can have a straight line parallel to x-axis. Try to understand. This is possible. This is possible. A straight line parallel to x-axis means object is at rest. Yes or no? What does it mean? It means the object is at rest. And then as the slope increases, its velocity is increasing. The velocity of the object is increasing. It's becoming more than 10 now. And then it's further increasing. Even this is possible. But if you do it like this, then it is not possible because the velocity is infinite. Clear, class? I hope your idea is very much clear now, that which type of motion is possible and which is not. Okay, so this is what the slope can tell us, and the inclination also. Okay, now let's start with the case number 3. Case 3. Object. This you will do on a new graph. Object moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second for 3 seconds, and then coming towards the initial position, and then coming towards the initial position with a velocity of 2 meters per second. Right one. This is it's okay, beta, if you are having one graph, Avni, we can't do anything, but it will be better if you do it on different graph. Later on, copy it on a different graph. Okay, beta, Avni. So the object is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second for 3 seconds. Understand, we are having it in two parts. So the object is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second for 3 seconds. After that, what the object is doing? Then the object is not moving away, but it is coming towards the initial position. What the object is doing? It is coming towards the initial position with a velocity of 2 meters per second. Okay, so this is our case 3. So we will study it in parts. So we start with the first. What it says, the object is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second for 3 seconds. Means zero, it is at rest. But what will be the displacement after 1 second? What will be the displacement after 1 second? So after 1 second, you will find the displacement is 4. After 2 seconds, the displacement will be 8, because it's moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second. How long it is moving? It is moving for 3 seconds. So after 3 seconds, the displacement will be 12. Clear? So we are done with the first part. So this is our first part. The object is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meters per second for 3 seconds. So we have drawn it. The object is moving with a velocity of 4 meters per second for 3 seconds. So you will find it. The first is 0, 0, 1, 4, 2, 8, and 3, 12. So how we get it? So we get a line like this. This is how we are getting a line. Okay, 1, 4, 2, 8, and 3, 12. Okay, now the important thing starts. Now you will find that the object is coming towards the initial position and the object is moving with a velocity of 2 meters per second. So can you say me, class, what will be the displacement after 4 seconds? Monish, brilliant answer. Om, think of your answer, beta. Om, what will be the displacement after 4 seconds? Om, think of it. Monish, your answer is right. Aditi, your answer is right. Krish, the velocity is 2 meters per second, Krish. Ruchir, right. Swam, Nishan, right. Priyanka, please check, beta. Swam. Right, beta, Swam. Priyanka, please check. Krish, right. Yes. Priyanka, please check your answer. Mahesh, very good, beta. Avni, no. Think of it. No, beta. Vidula. Beta, Vidula, after 4 seconds, what will be the velocity? You are not understanding the condition. Let me read the condition again. See, pay attention here. The object is traveling for 4 meters per second for 3 seconds. So it has traveled. Now, then the object is coming towards the initial position with a velocity of 2 meters per second. Now the object's velocity is 2 meters per second and it is coming towards the initial position. So can you say me what will be the velocity after 4 seconds? No, Om. It cannot be 40, no, beta. I'm talking about the displacement. It's a displacement versus time graph. Om, it's a displacement versus time graph, no, beta. So after 12, what the object is doing? After reaching 12, it's coming towards the initial position. Okay, or initial position pe kitne speed se aa raha hai? It's coming towards the initial position with a velocity of, see, let me show it with the help of an arrow. Dekho, your object move ho raha hai. This object is moving, and it reaches a distance of 12 meters. Okay. It reaches a distance of 12 meters. ओके ये 12 मीटर आ गया. अब उसके बाद क्या कर रहा है वो ऑब्जेक्ट? देन दैट ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द इनिशियल पोजीशन. सो द ऑब्जेक्ट इज नो मोर मूविंग इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. इट्स मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द इनिशियल पोजीशन एंड दिस टाइम द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज 2 meters per second. सो दिस इज द मोशन. इज मूविंग अवे and then it's coming towards. So at 4 seconds, how much will be the displacement? So at 4 seconds, the displacement will be 10. Why? Because after 12, it is coming towards and with a velocity of 2 meters per second. So that's why after 4 seconds, the velocity will be 10. Piyush, it cannot be 16. 16 kab hota agar wo कंटिन्यू मूव होता 4 meters per second की वेलोसिटी से. लेकिन 3 सेकंड के बाद क्या हुआ पीयूष? आफ्टर 3 सेकंड लुक एट द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट. आफ्टर 3 सेकंड इट्स कमिंग टुवर्ड द इनिशियल पोजिशन विद द वेलोसिटी ऑफ 2 meters per second. पीयूष, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो आफ्टर 4 सेकंड द वेलोसिटी विल नो मोर बी 12, बट आफ्टर 4 सेकंड इट विल बी 10. आफ्टर 5 सेकंड After 5 seconds, come on, say me the answer now, all of you. Very good, very good. After 6 seconds, very good. And after 7 seconds, very good. After 8 seconds, very good. And after 9 seconds, very good. After 9 seconds, it will be 0. Why? Look at this motion now. The object is moving towards the initial position with a velocity of 2 meters because 10, 8, 6, 4, 2 and 0. So what's the displacement after 4? 10. After displacement after 5, 8, then 6, then 4, 2 and 0. Let's plot the graph of this and see how our graph is. Please plot the graph. Very good, Om. Chalo, plot this graph quickly. Okay, now I want all of you to quickly find the slope of the second line, not the first line. I'm talking you to find the slope of the second line. Find out the slope of the second line. Not the first part, this part, the second line. Take arbitrarily any 2 points on this line from 3 seconds onwards, this line. I want you to find out the slope of this line from 3 seconds onwards. Find out the slope and same. No Ruchir, no Ruchir, your calculation is wrong. Nishant, your answer is wrong. Please find the slope properly. Ruchir and Nishant, your calculation is wrong, beta. Om, your calculation is wrong. No, Avni, that's correct, Avni. Swam, incorrect. Aditya, incorrect. Please use the correct formula. No, beta Monish, wrong. Do it properly. Take x1, y1 and x2, y2 properly. Pratik se usko. No, Monish, wrong. Only Avni has given the right answer yet. Acha, okay, no problem. I will solve it. No problem. Chalo. So let me solve the no beta Krish. Kya kar rahe ho tum log? Log nahi nikalte aa raha tum logo ko? Chalo. So I will take the points. Which point I am taking? So I am taking this point. Okay. Which is this point? Look at it. I am taking this point. This is my x1, y1. So x is 4. And y is 10. Okay, so my x1, y1. So my x is 4 and y is 10. Okay, so this is my first point. X is 4 and y is 10. And this is my second point. I take this point. Can you see? Here, x is 7 and y is 4. So x is 7 and y is 4. So x is 7. And y is 4. Okay, sure. So these are the two coordinates, x1, y1, x2, y2. 4, 10, and 7, 4. Now, the formula is y2 minus 1. What is y2? y2 is 4 minus y1. What is y1? 10. 4 minus 10 divided by x2 minus x1. What is x2? x2 is 7. And what is x1? x1 is 4. Yes or no? So 4 minus 10 divided by 7 minus 4. Now 4 minus 10 will be minus 6 divided by 7 minus 4. 7 minus 4 will be minus 3. Minus 6 divided by 3. Sorry, not minus 3. So minus 6 divided by 3. And what's the answer? So the answer is minus 2. What's the slope of the line? The slope of the line is minus 2. Okay, so what does the slope of the line indicate? So the slope of the line indicates the velocity. Very true. See, so what's the velocity? 2, isn't it? The object is coming towards the initial position with a velocity of 2 meter per second. That's why the velocity is coming 2. But the negative sign is there. And what is velocity? Velocity is a vector quantity. You remember? No, beta ohm, it's not retardation. Velocity is a vector quantity. And vector quantity has direction as well. And I told you when I explained you about vectors, I told you that a negative sign in front of a vector quantity represents opposite direction. What I said, it represents opposite direction. Means a negative sign. Understand this, a negative sign before a vector quantity indicates the opposite direction. So what we can get, we can find out that a negative sign before a vector quantity indicates opposite direction. Means what, beta? It means that here it's a negative sign, and you can definitely see that the object is coming towards the initial position. So as the object is coming towards the initial position, what can you say about the direction? So direction is opposite to the beginning. Initially the object is moving away, now the object is coming towards. So that's why the direction is coming out to be negative. Can the slope, Ruchir is asking, can the slope be minus? Definitely a slope can be minus. Whenever you find a straight line in this particular fashion, you will find its slope will always be negative, beta. Okay, if I have a slope like this, okay, assume I am having a slope like this. I am having a line like this. So if it's a line like this, these lines will always give me a positive slope. But if I am having a line like this, this is the line, the second line, then this line will always give me a negative slope. Yes, so we can definitely have a positive and the negative slope. Okay, yes, definitely we are going to discuss that. Okay, so I hope you are getting it, beta, that what does the negative slope indicate? The negative slope of the line indicates that the object is moving towards the initial position, means the negative sign before a vector quantity indicates the opposite direction, and that's why the object is moving in the opposite direction. All of you, is it very clear? Any doubt, beta? Anyone, any doubt? So we can quickly sum up today's discussion. What we have seen, that more is the slope of the line, more is the velocity of that object. Okay, and it can be parallel to x-axis, which is the indication that the object is at rest, but it cannot be parallel to the y-axis, because that represents the object is moving with infinite speed. And if the object is coming towards the initial position, then this is how the nature of the graph we will find, and the slope of this line will be negative, indicating that the object is coming, or the object is having opposite direction. Clear, class?